It's now just a week until Christmas, and the highest mountain in the Western Hemisphere is just 600 miles away. But after 178 days of cycling with often poor nutrition, the prospect of the climb is weighing on Mark's mind.
Getting to Aconcagua is one thing. Getting there in shape to be able to climb, to attempt to summit successfully, is a worry.
Mark's lost nearly 2 stone in body weight and needs to build his strength up. Something a Christmas present from home might just help with.
Mum sent out some Christmas cake, which is obviously meant for Christmas, but I'm in the middle of the Atacama Desert. It's 60 miles since the last place I could get supplies. It's incredibly nutritious and it's quite heavy, so I don't really want to carry it for another week, so I've decided that Christmas has come early and I'm gonna have some Christmas cake. Fantastic. It better be iced. Is it icing? Oh, brilliant. I got a Christmas cake. Look at this. Mum's Christmas cake. Look at that energy, just fruit and sugar and goodness and icing and... Oh, that's brilliant. Thanks, Mum. Sorry I couldn't wait for Christmas. Oh, a pile of Christmas cake. A big night's sleep. Anything's possible.
It's taken Mark 2 weeks of hard grind, but he's succeeded in crossing the Atacama. He's now in the sweeping foothills of the Andes. And whilst there may be signs of life, Mark is still all alone. And today is a special day.
It's Christmas. Merry Christmas. I got my Christmas decorations. I can go on the bike today. And I've woken up to thousands of ants in my tent. I don't know how they got into my tent, but a colony of ants I've already got at my breakfast. So, Christmas breakfast isn't looking great. Oh well. Woohoo.
No one has ever cycled the 11,000 miles between the highest mountains of North and South America, ascending both inside a single climbing season. After an extraordinary last push through Christmas and Boxing Day, Mark is finally approaching Mount Aconcagua.
Most people would prepare for a major climb by resting up, eating well, making sure they were in the best physical and mental shape. My preparation for climbing the highest mountain in the Western Hemisphere has to put mind and body through everything, every torment you could imagine for over half a year on the bike. I've made it. I've made it down the Americas from Denali to Aconcagua. It's just, at this point, it's just a massive, massive sense of relief. I've had a singular focus
overriding everything else for over half a year on the bike, and that's to get between Denali and Aconcagua within time to climb them, and I'm here.
I've put so much into this, there would be massive disappointment. I would be kidding myself if I didn't say that I would be gutted if I didn't make it to the top.
Aconcagua towers in the heart of the Andes at 22,841 feet. It's the highest mountain outside of Asia, and every year its extreme altitude and ferocious weather kills many an able climber. After 4 days of acclimatizing on the lower hills, Mark's arrived at just below 15,000 feet, Aconcagua Base Camp. You need to be with experienced climbers to attempt this mountain, so Mark is joining a small team. It's being led by veteran guide Damien. He's all too aware of the dangers, having lost a good friend to Aconcagua just last year.
It's like a chess game. You have to make one move and let the mountain do another move. And if you go too fast, you're going to lose.
Also supporting is fellow Argentinian and mountaineer Sebastian. And the summit team is completed with Russian climber,
hey guys,
Oxy.
So from here on up, it looks like it gets a lot steeper.
2.5 kilometers up.
Ah, that feels good.
I'm ready.
Oh, it's heavier than I thought.
From base camp up, with no mules, this is where the real climb begins. Carrying 25 kilograms, the next few days will reveal if Mark's physically capable of summiting at all.
I've not really walked for half a year. I've been on the bike for so long that it's such a different fitness, and my lower back and legs, they're gonna have to adjust pretty quickly. Trying to go to nearly 7,000 meters now I just don't know how I'm gonna react. I don't know how the body's gonna adjust.
It's hard to walk here at this altitude.
Lungs feeling good apart despite the thinning air, but my back, my shoulders, it's really, really painful. I'm not used to having this kind of weight in my back. It's such a different exercise than being on the bike.
For the next 3 days, the team moves up through Camp 1 and on to Camp 2, at just shy of 18,000 feet. Here, Damien receives news that a storm is on its way.
O sea que mañana es mejor día de cumbre.
They have a weather window of just 2 days to summit. Without the usual days to acclimatize, they're making a superhuman effort to reach high camp.
Yep, we are pretty much at the summit of Kilimanjaro.
High camp sits at over 19,000 feet. Up here, there's only 49% of the oxygen at sea level. And collecting snow for vital drinking water is energy sapping.
All right. Slowly, slowly.
Temperatures up here can drop to as low as minus 40 degrees, and with the weather turning, the only chance to summit will be before the high winds forecast later tomorrow.
Aconcagua is famous for its high winds more than anything.